Now you can save the people of Earth from the demonic spawn of hell from the comfort of your own toilet, thanks to Retroarch with this new update for iOS and Apple devices. Once again, this isn't quite the video I was hoping to put out today. There's still no developments with iOS 2 returning to the App Store, but hopefully it will soon. However, a large update for Retroarch was released with a few bug fixes and new cores that you may not have seen if you installed it on release day and haven't updated the app yet. Most of the games I enjoy are MS-DOS classics, so the addition of the PrBoom Doom Engine core and the DOSBox-Pure core are great. While the DOSBox-Pure core doesn't offer the user experience that iOS 2 did, DOSBox-Pure generally does an excellent job with MS-DOS emulation as a Retroarch core. Unfortunately, while the core itself works, I haven't really had a chance to test it out yet. Bluetooth keyboards work well on the iPad and in applications like ScumVM, but they're currently not supported on Retroarch for Apple devices. According to this post I came across on GitHub, the keyboard handling needs to be rewritten. Once I have a working keyboard and mouse, I'll take another look at DOSBox-Pure and emulating some MS-DOS classics on the iPad. In the rest of this short video, I'm going to touch on setting up the inputs for stylus games like Elite Beat Agents for the Nintendo DS, setting up the PrBoom Doom core, and I've got a couple of clips of PlayStation 1 games running to show you the performance of the PSX cores. Many, if not most, Nintendo DS games should now run at full speed on a modern iPhone or iPad. To get the stylus input working while I have a gamepad connected, this is what I had to tweak. In the main menu, navigate to Configuration and then Input Configuration. And turn on Automatic Mouse Grab and turn on Auto Enable Game Focus Mode. Then save the configuration just in case the Retroarch app crashes, as it's still somewhat unstable. That should enable stylus touchscreen input for games like Rhythm Heaven and Elite Beat Agents. Performance of the PlayStation cores is almost flawless even on my dated iPad. Screen recording tends to drop my frame rate a little, but even with it running I get close to 60 frames per second on almost all titles with little stuttering. The last thing I want to cover is the Doom Core PrBoom. PrBoom simply requires the commercial or shareware Doom 1 or 2 WAD files, which can be scanned into the Retroarch frontend like any other ROM. But if you just want to play the shareware version, you can download the required file right to your device using the content download feature in the online updater. This is a big update that may be a little limited in usability for now. But hopefully soon we'll have working keyboard code in Retroarch for iOS, and this could become a platform for classic MS-DOS gaming. That said, it's still worth updating for the improved performance. For now, I'll have to make do with an emulated Duke Nukem 64, because sadly I haven't had any luck getting the Quake core running either. I'll be back soon with a look at setting up DOSBox-Pure for Retroarch on iOS once it's all working. Thanks for watching!